On May 11th of 2023, something unusual began to occur on a section of the Hengill Volcano in Iceland. There, a section of Iceland Route 1 began to melt as a new geothermal feature seemingly appeared underneath a section of the road. This heated a small section of Route 1 to as high as 90 degrees Celsius, with reportedly some temperatures approaching 100 degrees Celsius, as best shown via these thermal images provided to me by the Just Icelandic YouTube channel, thank you by the way. Since asphalt, depending on its precise composition, can melt with temperatures as low as 54 degrees Celsius or 129 degrees Fahrenheit, the asphalt on the road has begun to deform and even melt. While as of the writing of this video, this isn't yet truly a hazard for vehicle traffic in my opinion, it might eventually become one as cracks eventually widen into potholes. All of this was caused by the sudden appearance of a new hot spring right underneath the section of the road having two potential causes. To answer the question on everyone's mind, no, this activity does not indicate that a volcanic eruption is about to occur at Hengill, which hasn't erupted in approximately 1900 years, as there is no ground uplift that would be associated with a magmatic intrusion, as you can see by this fairly flat line. For comparison, this is what the chart looked like during an uplift episode before the Fagradalsfjall volcano erupted in August of 2022. For context, like the other four volcanoes on the Reykjanes Peninsula, Hengill is not simply one large volcanic mass with a central vent, but rather encompasses a series of fissure systems spread out over a wide area. Within these areas are fairly common geothermal features related to bodies of magma which exist in the crust, including both fumaroles and hot springs. Since the section of road is merely 150 meters or 492 feet south of a known grouping of geothermal features referred to as the Hervorudalur geothermal area, the simplest explanation is that the background volcanic processes by random chance just created a new hot spring feature which happened to be partially underneath a paved road. This does not truly imply anything suspicious, as at volcanoes around the world, some which have not erupted for as many as 70,000 years, hot springs and fumaroles can regularly appear and disappear without an eruption ever occurring. This is what somewhat recently occurred at the Yellowstone Volcano when a new geothermal area began expanding around 2001, as what was previously an area filled with trees began to die, before becoming discolored, eventually being followed by the distinctive white color found at numerous geothermal features. Back at the new hot spring in Hengill, some surrounding vegetation is already dying off due to a presumably elevated level of various volcanic gas emissions alongside potentially acidic water being emitted. There is a good chance that a section of the Route 1 road may need to be partially rerouted and repaved elsewhere to bypass damage, which does not seem avoidable to the road at this point in time. However, there is also a second, less likely possibility which may have caused the formation of this hot spring. It is well known that geothermal plants can sometimes but not always produce one or two side effects. These potential side effects are earthquakes and changes to nearby geothermal features such as hot springs, fumaroles, or geysers if they exist nearby. In rare circumstances, this can even create a new geothermal feature, especially if water in a geothermal borehole partially escapes and goes in an unintended direction. Such a scenario occurred before at the Barentsky volcano in Russia in 1991. Yet, I do not have direct proof that the Helenshaidi geothermal power plant is the cause of this hot spring forming, as instead it is hypothetically possible in my opinion, although overall unlikely. The simplest explanation is that background activity randomly formed a new hot spring without the interference of a geothermal plant aiding in its creation. Thus, on my 0 to 10 opinion-based volcanic unrest scale, I would place the Hengill volcano at a 0, as this activity does not represent anything other than normal background volcanic activity. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.